Okay, everybody, what is up? ADS Play 101 here, and welcome to the Pikmin playthrough series. So, during this past Nintendo Direct in June, they announced that Pikmin 4 was going to be created, and I figure what better way to celebrate than to play through the entire series. So, I did a playthrough of the demo, and you know, when I was younger, I didn't get a chance to fully explore the Pikmin franchise. So this is my opportunity to not only play the game, but celebrate the release of Pikmin 4 whenever it gets out soon or whatever. I don't even think it has a release date yet. But let's jump in. Check these options. Sound. Turn it down just a little bit more. And let's see what we get into. The impact site. And there's Olmar, the original. I still remember when this game was new. My name is Captain Olmar. Traveling through space, my ship was struck by a meteor. I must have blacked out and I woke up on the surface of a weird planet. So many parts lost. The skeletal hull in my beloved dolphin is a painful sight. The engine is gone. I'm stranded. To make matters worse, my atmospheric sensors indicate this planet's environment contains high levels of poisonous oxygen. My life support systems can function only for 30 days, but if I can repair the dolphin, then, you know, better not think about it. Must find missing parts. Look at that, it's an onion. Stranding has appeared before me. I had barely begun my search when it reared up as if it were waiting for me. It then dropped a single seed. What is it? Is it alive? Is it a machine? It resembles a vegetable. My home planet. We call it an onion. I shall call this an onion too. The seed that onion dropped took root in the soil and now has produced an adorable little sprout. The sprout emits a strange light and sways back and forth without benefit of the wind. I cannot help but think it's calling me. I am compelled. The onions must look like our tomatoes. Historically, when I plucked the sprout, it turned out to be a living creature, not a plant. Picking it has done no visible damage. It just stands there staring at me. Its shape is similar to a Pick brand carrot. I love it so much, I believe I should call it a Pikmin. Here I am, stranded on a toxic planet, fighting to survive, and yet I'm intrigued. I must research this fascinating creature. I shall grab it and throw it with A. And call it to my side with B. Perhaps it will react if I press X or... Following controls appear to be some of the viewpoints. Snap camera behind. Rotate camera left line. Zoom. Change perspective. I must survive. I need to familiarize myself with these controls and my surroundings. Astonishing, the onion has sown more seeds. The smaller red pellet the Pikmin harvested cutting down a flower appears to be some type of food that they can propagate more Pikmin. The onion seems to be a sort of incubator. Needless to say, I studied this strangely. Never understood what do you do in Pikmin. It always seemed weird. Well, he's just a stranded guy. Omar is a stranded, I guess, astronaut or something from another planet. And he landed on a mysterious planet and he's trying to get back home. Wait a minute, did I pick the other ones? I did. Couple more caps. The Pikmin are as curious as children. They form groups to perform tasks that would be impossible for an individual. A glimmer of hope has begun to shine in my heart. If I can make use of their skills, perhaps I can fix my ship. I shall sum up all I've learned in Pikmin conduct. Approach and hold A to pick up sprouts. Press A to grab Pikmin. Release to throw. Call them. Hold L, holding a command. Control. L, Z are up. There's no mistake that my ship's engine rests before my very eyes. By a stroke of pure luck, I've already stumbled upon the most important piece of my ship. Damaged craft, fate has smiled upon me, but how will I get it back to the Dolphin? Like the Pikmin are like little henchmen. You're using them to help you rebuild your ship, carry things, fight for you. Many Pikmin seeds sprout at once. I find it rather tedious to pluck them from the ground individually. My wife always told me I was no good at routine tasks. I could try holding. I'm already doing that. There was time when I add Pikmin to my group, they become filled with excitement and flushed with bright color. At times, they revert to a pale hue to give off a dim glow. Paying close attention to these differences is bound to help me distinguish between Pikmin. This is who's going to help me get the engine. Oh, they're taking it directly to the ship. For whatever reason, I thought they was bringing that to the Onion for some reason. That's the ship part, duh. Oh, glorious, with the help of these Pikmin, I've taken a huge step back toward home. My ship can once again lift off. The glimmer of hope has begun. It's beginning to burn more brightly, but what has become of the remaining parts? That search starts tomorrow. They went in back. I somehow managed to launch the Dolphin but I was surprised to see the onion lift off with me. Perhaps the Pikmin cannot survive overnight on this planet's surface, or have they merely decided to join me for other reasons? Either way, it seems they will help me again tomorrow. The Dolphin is missing 29 parts, and I can recover them all. If I can't recover them all, I mean never return home to my family, planet Hokotake. Hokotate. Analysis shows life support systems will function for only 29 more days. How can I repair my Dolphin in such a short time? A dense forest is visible on the surface below. As it holds the keys to my survival, I'll name the forest Forest of Hope. I'll explore it tomorrow. Let's save. Going to the Forest of Hope. It's a yellow one. I'll knock down his door though. Took all that just to knock down that door? I'm going to carry that. Five up there. Like 44 of them now. Can't tear the door down. Well, I guess we're going on a bully mission. That thing. I think that's the other engine part over there. My cock has indicated to come in the noon. From now on, I must pay close attention to the sun meter and choose my axis accordingly, so it's best for me to review the monitor's data. Across the top of my monitor, sun meter is displayed at the bottom on my spacesuit damage meter. Pikmin gauges from the left. These numbers reflect Pikmin under my command, Pikmin on the field, and total Pikmin, including those in onions. So adjust my monitor, I can move R to rotate the camera, zoom, and... gang's all here. No wonder in the early games they let you just... They get 8. In a new game, it's like you ain't gotta worry about that as much. Eternal Fuel Dynamo, this should light things up. No more candles for me. Now I have recovered 2 out of 30 parts. If I can just find 3 more, I should be able to increase my ship's capabilities. I generally don't know if there's anything else I could do to just knock this wall down faster. Don't have a lot of time to do what you want, so. To increase the Dolphin's capabilities. While confirming the ship's status, I have taken the opportunity to repair my spacesuit. I recovered 2-3. It's another part all the way back there. I'm pretty sure it's another one back this way. They were flying off. Today's since impact, it appears that many of my ship's parts have landed in this region. If I can just recover the parts on my radar, I should be able to use my radar screen to improve my chances. But there seem to be many hostile life forms here. If I'm attacked and my spacesuit takes damage, I must return to my ship. Or a parrot. Said I left behind 16 Pikmin. Must be the ones I didn't get to. This door got knocked down over. The yellow ones. Yellow ones. color is different, but it seems to be a Pikmin nonetheless. First glance suggests it has, this one has some circles over it. And some circles I could be considered very large ears. Looks like they may weigh less than the others. In what ways may be different than a red? I must surely observe. Press and hold the Pikmin for a moment with A, then swap to another by pressing R. Tossed that little Pikmin all over the damn wall. So don't know how to get around that. Like some fire Pikmin or something like that. I do lost now. I don't know how the hell we're supposed to get him. How long am I supposed to do? I'm lost. I'm genuinely lost. Because it's midday. I can't knock down that wall. I am genuinely, there are no yellow Pikmin on your team. Well, shit, how am I supposed to get them? They had one right there. I honestly don't even know how the hell I was supposed to... I'm confused. I don't know what to do with these damn things. I thought I was supposed to get some yellow ones and like bring them over here, but I'm supposed to be doing something with these little rocks. I'm assuming they're supposed to help me like knock down these walls. But I can't get no damn where. Okay, I see what they want me to do. I see what they want me to do. I'm gonna have to knock out, go back. When they get the yellow ones, I gotta move it to the yellow one here. I see exactly what they want me to do. Really intriguing to some of you. A local variety of grass produces a yellow nectar. When the Pikmin drink this delicacy, they instantly mature into flowers. This is apparent. Pikmin's favorite seems to be full of nutrition. Closer observation needed to determine the strength of these particular Pikmin. I wonder if now I can pick up them. Let me see. that's not gonna work. I'm gonna have to knock down the yellow ones and guide them over to the yellow onion. I thought they would have went there automatically, but apparently not. I know how they want me to move them now. Its impact. The Pikmin I did not bring back to the onion all vanished overnight. It may be that they have fallen prey to the planet's nocturnal creatures, an ugly thought. Perhaps that is why they follow me into the atmosphere. I'm starting to grasp the cycles of life on this planet.